Hello friends, in this video lecture I am going to show you how to calculate current in electrical circuit using PowerPoint and VBA. I am going to explain you how to use VBA to calculate current through the circuit using formulas of current and resistances. For that purpose I have taken here a simple parallel circuit. When we teach parallel circuits to students, we draw circuits like this. So here I have a circuit with battery of MAP and two resistances R1 and R2 are parallel to each other. So we show total resistance, that is R equal to R1 parallel R2, and using that formula of parallel circuit we get here R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2, that is total resistance of the circuit. This we show to the students. Total current through the circuit, it is I is equal to E upon whatever effective resistance of the circuit, and then we calculate current through R1 using Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's law and so on, and we get that value I1 is equal to total current I times R2 upon R1 plus R2, and current through R2, it is I2 is equal to I into R1 upon R1 plus R2. These formulations we teach to the students in classroom. Now we have to make comparison between currents I1 and I2 depending upon resistances R1 and R2. If we see formula for R1, I1 and I2, if R2 is more, I1 is more and I2 is less. So in this way we have to make comparison between currents. So suppose we want to show comparison numerically, then we have to take different values of R1 and R2, different values of EMFs and so on, and then we have to calculate that. So I will make here one calculator using macros in PowerPoint, and then we can change different values of, we can take different values of R1, R2, E, and we will get corresponding current, resistance, I1, I2 and so on, and you will be able to show the students whatever comparison between currents I1 and I2 depending upon values of resistances R1 and R2. So here I will go to PowerPoint slide. This is PowerPoint slide and I have already taken this one. Now I have to make here calculator. So here first I will take rectangle, and in this I will write input. Whatever input I have to give, I can increase its font also. Now I will require here input EMF of the battery and resistance R1 and resistance R2. So here first give here notations. So first I will take here E, then I will give notation for R1. So here R1, then I will give for R2 also. R2. So these are three inputs I have to give. Now here to give values I will use text box in ActiveX control. So here you will have developer tab in PowerPoint. Go to that developer tab and here you have ActiveX controls, here controls. So here you will see text box, here label, then here you have spin button, command button and so on. So I will take this text box here and I will drag here. Now this is text box in which I will give value of E. Now I will take this, so this is first text box. Now this is text box 2, that is used for R1. Now I will take next text box. This is text box 3. I will use for R2, and then I can have their units also. So simply write here. Here I can write in volts. Then here I can write ohm. And that ohm here again. So these are three input boxes for E, R1, R2 respectively. Then I will again go to developer tab and I will use here command button. So this is command button. Now right click here and go here and edit command button. So I can change text on the command button. So I will take first calculate I and R. Calculate I and R. So here I will again take here insert. So I will give here notation R, and here somewhere here I will give notation I. Again I will use text boxes in which you will get value of R and I. So I will take that from developer tab. So this is text box in which I will get value of R. I will take, this is text box number 4. Now text box number 5 in which I will get value of current. Then again I will take here command button here and I will edit text on this command button. So edit this text, and here I will take calculate I1 and I2. I1 and I2. And then here I will take here I1. And here I2. Again I will take text boxes here. So now this is text box number 6 in which I will get value of current, and this is text box number 7 in which I will get value of current I2. Here again I will give units. So adjust it properly. So here ohm, this is unit for this. Now I will get current in ampere. So I will use here ampere. So I have made arrangement. Now I have to write macro for this. So here we will write macro here using calculate I and R command button. So just click on this and then right click and go to view code. If we press view code, VBA window will open, and in this VBA window we got here private serve command button 1 underscore click function, and here end serve. Now in this I will calculate R and E. For that purpose we will require variables E, R1, R2, I and R. So we will declare that variables. So team E, R1, R2, R, I as double, because these will be real variables. Now what is R1? So what is E? E will be equal to whatever value entered in the text box 1. So write val in bracket, now text box 1 dot text here. Now R1 is equal to again val, now text box 2 dot text. So whatever text I write there, that will be converted into value. Now R2 will be equal to val text box 3 dot text. So now these three are inputs. Now we have to calculate R. So R is equal to, you know, R1 star R2 divided by R1 plus R2, and that is the denominator I have taken in one bracket. And then I is equal to E upon R. Then I have to place R in text box 4 and E I in text box 5. So simply write here text box 5 dot value will be equal to R. So whatever value of R that is placed as a value in text box 5, then text box 4, not 5, text box 4, and in text box 5 value is equal to I will be placed. So now go to PowerPoint. So I have written small macro, go to PowerPoint, and if we run show, and if we place here value 6, suppose 5, 3 and 6. So E is 6 volts, R is 3 ohm, R2 is 6 ohm. And if we calculate, press calculate I and R command button, you will get value R equal to 2 ohm by formula, and I is equal to 3 ampere by formula, whatever formula given on this slide. Suppose we take here value 5 and then calculate. So I got here R is equal to 2.72727272 and so on. So I will format this and I will take up to 2 decimal places only. So for that purpose I have to make small change in macro VBA. So here I will write here text box 4 dot value is equal to R. So I will format this value. So format in bracket R means R is value that is given to text box 4, and then format for printing R, it is written in double quote. So double quote hash comma hash 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 dot 00.00 means 2 decimal places, and complete here bracket. Similarly, I can write here format I comma double quote hash comma hash 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 dot 00 this one. And now go in PowerPoint and see your calculation. So now here values are given. Suppose I press calculate I and R again. So I got 2.73, means that is converted into two decimal places. So in this way we can calculate R and I. Now here I have second command button that will calculate I1 and I2. So formula here given for I1 and I2 are these: I R2 upon R1 plus R2, I2 is I R1 upon R1 plus R2. So we require R1, R2 and I. Now I is in text box 5, R1 and R2 in text are in text box 3 and 4, 2 and 3 respectively. So I have to take values from that. So now right click on second command button and view code. So second command button appears here now. Private sub command button 2 underscore click. Now in this I will take variables. So dim R1 comma R2 comma I comma I1 comma I2 as double. Now here R1, here I have already written R1, so I will copy these two and I will place here. What is I? I is equal to, this is in text box 5, so I can write here text box 5 dot value. This is formatted value, so it will take that value directly. And now I will calculate I1. I1 is equal to I star R2 divided by R1 plus R2. And here I2 is equal to I star R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Now I have to place these values in text box number 6 and 7. So here I will copy this and I will paste here, and I will take here 6. Now in this I will print value I1, and text box 7, in this I will print value I2. Now go to PowerPoint and check it. So here suppose I take here 7, 8, then first I will calculate 3.43 and 2.04. So I got R equal to 3.43 ohm and I equal to 2.04 ampere. Now if we press command button second, calculate I1 and I2, you will get values of I1 and I2. So 0.87 ampere, and I2 is 1.17 ampere. So in this way you can change values of E, R1 and R2, and according to that you will get R, I, I1 and I2. Now suppose I want to give another values, then I have to clear all these. So for that purpose I will make slight change here. I will take another command button here and I will edit text on that. So press here edit and I will take here reset. reset. Then click on this reset command button and right click view code. So here you will get private sub command button 3 underscore click bracket and end sub. In between that we will write text box 1 dot value is equal to double quote only, so null. So it will clear value in text box 1. So same one I will use for text box 2, text box 3, text box 4, text box 5, text box 6 and text box 7. So simply make here changes: text box 2, text box 3, text box 4, text box 5, 6 and 7. And now go in PowerPoint and see effect. So if I press here reset, all values are clear. Now you can give new set 12, 8, 4. Then first I will calculate R and I, then calculate I1 and I2 and see here. Since R1 is more, I1 is less, and R2 is less, so I2 is more. And if you see here, I1 equal to 1.50, I2 is equal to 3.0 and I is equal to 4.50. And we know according to Kirchhoff's law, I1 plus I2 is equal to I. Now you can reset here. And now suppose we give here 12, here 5, and in next text box suppose we give 10 and calculate this. And calculate this. Now see here, R1 is less, so I got I1 more and I2 less. So in this way you can show to the students values of I1 and I2 in parallel circuit. Now you can modify this code for number of parallel resistances also. So in this way we can use macros in PowerPoint to simulate electrical circuits. So this is simple attempt I have made. If you like my video, I request you to subscribe the channel. Thanks very much.